The national government's total outstanding debt reaches a new record high of more than 10.7 trillion pesos in March. The Treasury Bureau says that this is 3.5% higher than the national government's debt last February. They attribute the rise to the net issuance of government securities. Of the total debt, 7.74 trillion pesos, or 72%, come from domestic sources, while 3 trillion pesos, or 28%, are from external sources. This says the Philippine government has been borrowing heavily to finance both its infrastructure push and its COVID-19 response efforts. Philippine headline inflation in April remains steady at 4.5%. This is the fourth straight month that inflation rose above the government's target range of between 2 to 4%. The 4.5 April inflation print is, however, well within the Philippine Central Bank's 4.2 to 5% target range. Higher food and transport costs affected the rise in the prices of goods at 22 and 17%, respectively. Inflation in the National Capital Region hit 3.7% in April, lower than the national average of 4.7%. BPI's lead economist, June Neri, says that asset prices need to be closely watched as well.
While it could be true that inflation is transitory, and therefore there is no need to hike until next year, there is also that possibility it can persist, no? Because prior to the pandemic, the trend of inflation was actually upwards. So asset prices will always be volatile in an environment where the policy rate is too far or much, much lower than the current inflation rate, because there's always the concern that the central bank could actually move to the opposite direction.
A proposal at the Philippine Congress for mandatory vaccinations gets the backing of the presidential advisor on entrepreneurship, citing informal surveys among companies. But for an employer's group, the move is unnecessary. Alvin El Chico tells us why.
Potential side effects and religion are just some of the reasons safety engineer Stan Ortiz get from workers who do not want to take COVID vaccine. In an informal survey, only around 70% of his colleagues want to be vaccinated.
First namin na ginawa is survey muna kung sino yung willing to get vaccinated. Then after nung nakita namin kung sino yung mga nag-decline, yun doon kami nag-focus. Doon kami nag-focus na one-on-one na lang sila. Okay. Kung ano yung reason bakit ayaw nila mag-vaccine, then ano yung pwede namin gawin to convince them.
But the 70% acceptance rate in Stan's company is even higher than some firms the Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship, Joey Concepcion, had surveyed. Concepcion hopes the memorandum from the Labor Department strongly encouraging workers to take the vaccine will help lessen vaccine hesitancy. According to Concepcion, the target is to get 80 to 90% vaccination among workers to achieve herd immunity.
Yung mga supervisor managers pa rin namin ang kailangan very instrumental sa pag-convince sa mga empleyado na talagang kailangan. Kasi kung kalahati or let's say 70% sa isang shift ang kukuha ng vaccine, yung iba, the others are also at risk. No? Kasi yung efficacy ng mga vaccine, hindi naman 100%.
For the Employers Confederation of the Philippines, the number of workers who want to be vaccinated is slowly going up. And President Duterte's televised vaccination will convince some workers to take the vaccine.
Noong una, mababa talaga. Pero ngayon, pataas ang pataas eh. Ang mga question nga sa amin ngayon, sa mga kumpanya, sir, bakit po kami hindi kasali sa priority?
That's why for ECOP, there's no need to make the vaccinations mandatory. But for Concepcion, if the herd immunity is not achieved, the government has the option to push for legislation that will make vaccination mandatory in order to revive the economy. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.